I don't know what it is.
Well, we're going to find out here in a second.
You know, it's funny. I looked, I was like, where's my bobber? It's probably small bass. I can't.
It's fighting whatever it is. It's fighting good. Dude, get that fish in.
That is not a small bass. That is not a small bass.
What's up, Yens guys? Welcome back to another episode of Fishing PA with Ryan Reed. It's officially May 26th, and that means we made it to Memorial Day weekend! I don't know about you guys, but I spent about 9 hours out in the yard today, so I am ready to talk some fishing. So for this episode, I really wanted to get back to focusing on PA lakes. So what I thought I would do is give you guys my top 10 lakes here in the state of Pennsylvania. In addition to that, I want to provide at least one tip regarding the lake to help you guys catch more fish. So with that said, let's go ahead and get started. Number 10, Conneaut Lake. Conneaut Lake can be found in Crawford County, and it's roughly 230 acres. The reason that I chose Conneaut Lake is for its pike and muskie fishing. My tip for Conneaut Lake is for you guys to find weedy bays and utilize crankbaits like grandmas or jerkbaits like phantoms in pockets of those weeds to produce pike. Number 9, Lake Wilhelm. Lake Wilhelm can be found in Mercer County and it's 1,860 acres. I chose Lake Wilhelm primarily for its walleye fishing. In May and June, you guys can troll or windrift nightcrawler worm harnesses in roughly 8 to 15 feet of water during the day. And at dusk or at night, you guys want to cast or troll stick baits around points and weed lines in about 4 to 6 feet of water to produce fish. Now in July, the walleyes run deeper. So what you guys want to do is grab your Hottentots, perch or fire tiger patterns, find the old stream channel from launch 2 to the dam and stay in about 18 to 24 feet of water with those Hottentots, and again, you will produce walleye. Number 8, Lake Arthur. Lake Arthur can be found in Butler County. Lake Arthur is 3,225 acres. The reason I chose Lake Arthur at number 8 is primarily for its muskie fishing. My tip for Lake Arthur is that all of the game fish in that lake really focus on eating allwife. So what you guys want to do is you find the allwife schools and you will find every single species of fish in that lake. However, muskie fishing can be really good, but my tip for fishing muskie is for you guys to troll or cast along deep weed edges early morning or late evening, especially around Neely's Point, Bear Run, or the Three Eastern Fingers. Number 7, Yellow Creek.
Yellow Creek's found in good old Indiana County,
and it's 720 acres. My tip for Yellow Creek is for you guys to go to the State Park Boathouse and launch at that first launch and stay in that first bay. Throw spinnerbaits and jerkbaits in that bay, and you'll continue to catch pike all day long. Number 6, Loyalhanna Dam. Loyalhanna Dam can be found in my home county, Westmoreland, and it's roughly 480 acres. Loyalhanna Dam was created by the Army Corps of Engineers. Now, Loyalhanna has a wide variety of fish, but it's really awesome for crappie, bass, sauger, and muskie. I usually spend a good bit of time fishing for panfish in this lake, but my tip is twofold. First tip is to throw swim baits for lunker bass. Secondly, find the wood to smack on the crappies. Early season, those crappies are piled up along wood piles and brush and branches and stumps. All you got to do is put on a fat head, on a hook and a bobber, and you guys can crush the crappie all day long. Now, personally, I've had over 100 fish days there at Loyal Hannah, which is why it's so high on my list. A lot of guys will complain about the water color and how dirty the water is down there. But what you guys have to understand is it's a reservoir. It's a dam. So there's probably going to be a lot of debris because the water level is changing. It makes it a great lake, especially for crappies. Number 5, High Point Lake. High Point Lake can be found in Somerset County, right along Mount Davis. You guessed it, the highest point in Pennsylvania. The lake is 338 acres. Now, High Point is home to some really, really big bass. My tip for you guys, for bass, is to go out and pick up an angry monkey and throw it all day long. The angry monkeys will produce really big bass, and High Point being a big bass water with really good weed edges and structure points, you're going to find lunker fish. If you guys want to go out and catch pike and pickerel, cast weed edges. Dan and I always find weed lines off of several points, and we have caught pike and pickerel on crankbaits and jerkbaits. High Point is one of my favorite lakes because of the weed structure, and because it just holds monster fish. However, it's tough to fish High Point later in the year because when the weeds come up fully, it doesn't give you a lot of space on the lake. Number 4, Pimatuning. Pimatuning Lake is in Crawford County and it's 17,088 acres, and I believe that to be the second largest lake in the state of Pennsylvania. So my two tips for you guys regarding fishing Pimatuning have to do with walleye fishing and muskie fishing. Now, both walleye and muskie are shallow in the early spring. However, muskie like the north end of the lake because it warms up quicker. So if you guys go and you throw a 6-inch crankbait 10 feet behind the boat in the prop wash, you'll catch muskie early in the season. Number 2, fishing walleyes in the summer can be difficult because the walleyes move deeper. However, you can catch walleyes the same way you can catch them when they're shallow because they relate to the same structure. So go out there, throw on your worm harnesses, your chartreuse blades, throw on your bottom bouncers, and fish that cover. Wind drift and troll, fish that cover on the lake in deeper water, and you guys will produce more walleye. Number 3, Lake Glendale. Lake Glendale can be found in Cambrian County in Prince Glitzen State Park. Lake Glendale is about 1,600 acres, and it's known for its walleye and its muskie fishing. Now, my tips are regarding muskie and walleye fishing as well. First and foremost, muskie fishing in July and August. Focus on trolling Crooked Run Campground all the way to the dam, running large crankbaits 10 to 20 feet down in 20 to 30 feet of water. Or you guys can try working bucktails in weed beds all throughout the lake. Now, walleye fishing, early in the morning, late at night, you'll find the walleyes in 6 to 8 feet of water. Again, you guys can troll or wind drift worm harnesses to produce a lot more fish. It's worth me stating that Lake Glendale is my favorite lake in the state of Pennsylvania. Again, my family took me camping there when I was younger. We always had fun at Lake Glendale, and I've caught a lot of fish there. I've seen a lot of muskie there, and I've seen a lot of big bass caught there. It's just one of those confidence lakes for me that I truly love fishing here in the state of PA. Number 2, Kinzu, the Allegheny Reservoir. Now, the Allegheny Reservoir is found in northern PA up around Warren and McKean counties, and it also goes into New York. The Allegheny Reservoir is 21,180 acres and about 24 miles long. Now, Kinzu is known for a lot of different species of fish. Again, I'm going to focus on walleye and muskie because that's what I would primarily fish there. In May and June, walleyes are found anywhere from 5 feet to 20 feet of water in bays with inlet streams, and on sloping points. So focus your attention in 5 to 20 feet of water on those features to produce more walleye at Kinzu. Now musky fishing. In May and June, the muskies are around stump fields and fallen trees, and they like to hang out in that 8 to 15 feet of water range. Also, the muskie like to suspend off the main lake points and over creek channels in large bays. So again, focus your attention trolling and casting these types of areas to produce more muskie. Number one, the greatest lake in the state of Pennsylvania, Lake Erie. Lake Erie is 9,910 square miles of water. Now, Lake Erie is known for its premier perch, walleye, and steelhead fisheries. However, you can catch just about any species of fish that you would like if you just find the right charter or you get out there and you do your research. Lake Erie is just a premier fishery. Whether you're fishing the tributaries of elk or walnut, or you're fishing off of Catawba Island, Lake Erie is the greatest destination for any sports fisherman here in the state of PA. My one tip for you guys is to get out there and look at these outdoor shows and find yourself a premier guide to go out with. I highly recommend Double D Guide Service off of Catawba Island because they are outstanding, from lodge to customer service to boat, cleaning fish. Everything was absolutely fantastic with them. So get out there, get yourself a good guide service, and get up there and catch some of those fish on Lake Erie. All right, guys. So those are my top 10 lakes here in the state of Pennsylvania. Hopefully the few tips that I gave you guys is something beneficial that will help you learn a little bit something new about each one of those lakes. A couple other things I want to mention before we end this episode. First thing is my Explore PA t-shirt here. For you guys to find new lakes and to find new streams and bodies of water to get out there and fish, you guys have to get out there and explore. And one tool that will help you do that is the Pennsylvania State Parks and State Forest Passport Book. This passport book was a program that was created a few years back, and it actually lists every state park in the state. Now, what's neat about this is you guys can go out and you can actually get stamps when you visit the park office. But what's nice about this is a great resource for you guys to get out there and explore PA, whether you guys want to do some hiking, you guys want to do some fishing, or even if you want to do some hunting, because there are opportunities to do all three of those things at state parks in a lot of different areas around the state of Pennsylvania. Now, we have a beautiful state here in PA, and I'm very proud to live here. So that's why I wanted to bring this up. Get out there and explore PA. Take a look at the passport books. It's a great program, and find new waters to fish. Lastly, I just want to say there are many lakes that didn't make it onto my top 10 list. There are lakes like Lake Wallenpaupack, or lakes like Keystone Power Dam. There's a lot of smaller lakes like my home lakes, like Acme Dam and Green Lake and Twin Lakes. I didn't mention them in this episode. However, all of these lakes, there's always opportunities to catch fish. So again, if I missed one, maybe you guys use this as an opportunity to tell me what your favorite lakes are. That way, maybe I can take a look at visiting a new lake this year and get out there and learn something new myself. So if you guys want to leave me a comment below on your favorite lakes or your top lakes in PA, it's always welcome. Now, if you guys like this episode, please like the video. If you guys like the content overall, please subscribe to my channel. I just want to thank you guys very much for your time. Hopefully you guys can get out fishing real soon. Take care.